Welcome, everybody. We are going to make some tracks inside Plasticity today. And as you can see, is for this example here, I have these tracks for my little tracked vehicle here. Basically, I designed the tracks and then built the vehicle around it, kind of backwards in the way you should have done it, but that's just how I did it on that one. So we're going to quickly show you how I went about designing this. I'm going to turn off perspective. And I'm going to go ahead and just open up a new scene. All right, I'm going to go on the right side here. Now I'm going to go through this pretty quickly. If you're unfamiliar with some of the commands I'm using, definitely go check out the Plasticity 101 playlist on YouTube there. Wealth of knowledge for you. So we're going to draw a circle real quick. This is going to be our main drive wheel, or one of them anyways. We're going to go ahead and duplicate that. I do have the shortcuts that I'm pressing up on the screen, so if you need to pause and see what I'm doing, feel free. We're going to keep these guide wheels down here like this, make them a little smaller, maybe a little bit bigger. Let's see. It really doesn't matter. It's whatever shape you want to make. I'm going to drag these out just a little. Okay, I'm going to do Alt-X, keeping everything symmetrical for the time being. I still don't like that position. Let's drag them out a little bit. All right, X. There we go. Now we're going to set up our guide for the tracks. So I'm going to draw out a couple lines here. Cool trick with Plasticity, it'll make tangent lines. So pay attention, see where I started the point, then I come up here. Tangent, tangent, perfect. Made a perfectly tangent line. Like I said, you can go check out my Plasticity tutorials or 101 guide there. It basically goes over a lot of commands for you. And we're just making some tangent lines here. Perfect. All right, I'm gonna duplicate these guys real fast. Keep them in their own group there and hide them. Now I'm gonna go ahead and trim everybody. Okay. Grab everybody, join them together. Now it's just one constant curve. And I bring our circles back there. Now it's time to make a drive gear. We only need to make one for now. If you hit tab, you get both sides there. That's what we want. Go up front here. I'm gonna cut out a section here for the gears. And just use our central dividing line there to make duplicates, and Shift I. We're going to imprint those onto that. Only did one side of it. That's okay. We'll just go extend edges. And we'll make our big gear section here. Okay, select the whole thing here. Oh, no, I want the whole object. Scale them down just a little bit. Get it to go the right direction there. And what I'm doing, I'm trying to line up that guideline to the center of the gears. All right. And this guy is not wide enough here. First, I'm going to delete any redundant topology. There we go. Now it solidified it a little bit better. Don't have all these extra lines in here. And let's go ahead. I'm just going to select faces. Select the whole thing. There we go. Now, oops, I don't want him. There we go. These guys either. Now we just got him, scale, and I'm just scaling the faces just to make these portions a little wider, because this is where your track's going to be, so that's the width of your track. All right, I think we're okay there. You can always come back and fix it later. And we're going to do a little cutout on the inside here, just to make it look more like a drive wheel. Add a chamfer to it. All right, looks good. Ink. Extend these out just a little bit. All right. All right, so we can see our inner portion here. So let's go ahead and draw a rectangle there using that center, that point of that curve to help us out. Tap it. Nope. Nope, that's fine. Switch over to point select so we can drag things around. We can readjust this curve a little bit, scale it. We don't want it to cut that far down, so let's bring them up. Okay. All right, I think we're doing okay. Let's go ahead and go to our all selection mode, select the curve. We're going to do a radial ray. We'll see how this guy looks. That's going to make some real narrow cuts there, so let's go ahead to scale overall. Radial array again. Let's try that. Use it as a cutter. Cut that up. And deselect the center portion here. Okay. We now have our drive gear. Let's look up top real quick. Let's add a few bevels real fast. Nope. I just want edge select. Okay, go ahead and add your bevels. Now, let's go ahead and select this guy. Nope, not that guy. Let's turn off X-ray. Create a duplicate. And I am going to disable this guy so I don't keep on accidentally selecting him. Select that edge. That edge. Loft. Join them together. Alt select that outer edge and patch them. Okay. Another patch on the other side. All right. Now he is a solid object. Go ahead, select that. There we go. Now let's add our little pins here. I'm going to use this as temporary. Show you a little trick here. You can, I want it right there. I want it dead center. Thank you. Okay. We're going to slide them over, move command. And since I am using a temporary construction plane, if I do Alt X now, as you can see, it is now mirrored on. This is the new world center until that construction plane's gone. Which comes in quite handy. Select that. That. Extrude in. Play with the angle, draft angle. There you go. We can get rid of these guys now. X. Get that construction plane off. Let's select the top. Do the same trick. Oops. Gotta select him. And as you can see, and now mirrored it on itself. There we go. We can turn that off. We don't need him anymore. Cool. All right. So now we've got one little piece here. Let's go ahead and make our center tread here. Use that world centered again to help us. There we go. They're both selected on each side. Loft. Perfect. And we'll select that. Face. Hit extrude. Now we can get our tread in here. Hit B to make it a new body. We don't want it to weld to anything here. Let's take a look at it. And this is kind of guesstimate in here, so you may have to work with it a little bit. We're going to go with there. Need to get rid of that extra sheet now. So now we'll select this, all four corners here. And we'll add a fillet to it. All right, cool. We now have our basic tread and gear hookup here on the drivetrain. So now we can test it out. So if we select our two that we want to curve array, do F, lookup curve array, select our, there we go. And if you hold down the shift and do your center wheel down, you can add copies. Let's take a look at this. Okay, so looking at it, it looks like it's too long. So let's go ahead and adjust that. We just need to select these faces here. All right, go ahead and do G. We're going to do a move face command. Bring him in just a little bit. Let's see if that helps us out. All right, let's do our curve array again. I got him on my favorites, so. Take a look on the other side. It's not too bad. I think we just need to move this guy in just a little bit. This is not exact by any means. So mechanically, I don't know how well it would work. But for the sake of being artistic, it works just fine. You get the look that you're looking for. All right. So I think this is going to be as close as we're going to get. One more test. Yeah, it's a lot better. It definitely gives the representation of a track. So let's go ahead and finish them up. I'm going to get these two edges here. Control 2, select the outer perimeter. All right. We're going to use a little symmetry here to make something quickly. Do Shift A for your line command. Draw some lines in here. K for the knife tool. All right. Now we got a couple extra pieces in here. Let's select him. Select him. Extrude up. All right. Perfect. Now we still got that construction plane that we can use. So Alt X. Oop. Now select him. Alt X. Mirror. Merge halves. Maybe we'll bring him down a little bit. He was a little aggressive there. Do Control R, isoprene, tab. Just add a little extra detail in here. Yeah, we'll do that. That looks good. And it should already be symmetrical. We'll just double check because we still have it. on a temporary construction plan. Cool. It's whatever you want. This design is just, just to make it look cool when it's all wrapped around. Let's go ahead and fix this guy up here. Using the Alt to get the nice smooth borders there. Like I said, you can go check out that Plasticity 101. That's going to give you a lot of these quick tips and everything. Let's turn off construction plane. I just need to make another one of these. Alt X. There we go. Now we got both sides of our tread. And select the middle one there. And do our curve array. All right, now we got our tracks. Let's go ahead and just get our extra wheels in here. I'm going to turn on, get rid of, nope, I want those on. Go down to all these curves down here. And we'll go ahead and just hide them. All right, so let's get our wheel here, our drive wheel. There we go. Now I can select them. I'm going to do Control D for the place command. And I want to find, there we go, center centroid, which is dead center of that that drive hub. This way I can perfectly place him over there. Escape him out. We just want to rotate that gear so it matches a little better. Turn off X-ray so I can see it better. So yeah, not perfect, but from a distance, it's going to look just fine. So let's go ahead and do a wheel, a guide wheel down here. Okay. Boolean him together. Done. Just add in a little extra detail. That's it. Nothing too fancy. All right, he's kind of embedded in there a little too much, so we're going to go ahead and scale him down just a little. Okay. We use our rectangular array. There we go. And we'll just do Shift-D, duplicate, bring him up. And there you go. Quick set of tank treads. Quick and easy in Plasticity. Hope you guys learned something today. Give me a shout. Tell me what you thought. And we'll catch you in the next video. You guys have a good day.